Well, Georgetown students will not give credit to the commander-in-chief for the takedown of ISIS leader al-Baghdadi, but they praise Obama for bin Laden's death. Listen to this.
So do you think President Trump deserves credit for the killing of the ISIS leader al-Baghdadi?
I mean, I guess it happened despite him.
Donald Trump.
I'm going to take that as a no.
Okay, great, whatever, but it still had someone dying.
Would you say the same thing about President Obama?
Of course, Obama handled the news of the killing of Osama bin Laden with more grace.
I think he does. I'm a hypocrite.
Great, whatever, but it's somebody dying. Joining us to weigh in on the campus confusion, Campus Reform Digital reporter Eduardo Neret. Thank you so much for joining us. Wow, very eye-opening.
Yeah, thanks for having me. This double standard is Trump derangement syndrome. So instead of being able to look at both scenarios, President Obama getting Osama bin Laden and President Trump getting al-Baghdadi, and say they both deserve credit for authorizing those raids, we see these students and their hatred for President Trump preventing them from looking at the situation objectively and from giving him any credit. And it's a shame, because this is something that we should be able to come together as a country and celebrate this great moment when we nab this terrorist leader. But it's not just happening on campuses. Over the weekend, we saw President Trump booed at the World Series. We saw the mainstream media react negatively to the getting of al-Baghdadi. So this is just another sad moment where hatred for President Trump is extending far and beyond moments that we should come together as a country.
I mean, and then one of the most surprising things to you was that we should not be celebrating as Americans the death of al-Baghdadi at all.
Yeah, some of these students came out and said, well, I don't know if I want to go on the record celebrating someone's death, or should we be taking credit for someone's death? And that's pretty insane to me. And at the Leadership Institute's Campus Reform, we cover a lot of stories where professors are out on the record telling students, President Trump is like Hitler, President Trump is a Nazi. And so when students are receiving that information day in and day out, it's almost no surprise that they would think these insane things about terrorist leaders or these insane things about their own president. And so it really puts it into perspective for us and for the viewers as to how these professors are teaching their students on college campuses.
Yeah. Do you think it's just an indication of what's being taught by these professors, but do you also think that it's really overwhelmingly what they are seeing on social media and what they're hearing from the mainstream media?
Well, it's a bit of both. And like you said, if it's on social media, if it's in the mainstream media, but it's also in the classroom, it's also in your dorm hall, it's also amongst your friends, if you're getting this information in every aspect of your daily life, you're not going to get another viewpoint. In fact, your crazy viewpoints, your subjective viewpoints on President Trump are going to be justified. They're going to be validated if everyone who you spend time around also agrees the same way. So this is just another double standard. And we also see the liberal double standard, because obviously President Obama on campuses is seen favorably. We saw that with some of the student responses, where they were willing to give credit to President Obama for getting bin Laden, but then looking at Trump and saying, oh, well, you know, I don't think he deserves credit.
Yeah. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it. Some eye-opening reporting for us this morning. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Well, the time now is about half.